I am like super excited. I'm on my way to just the outskirts of Graz, literally just 20 minutes out of the old town of Graz, not even 10 kilometers, to an installation of 8,213 square meters of solar thermal installation for their district heating program. It's a massive 5 megawatts. Let's go and see how this was done. The original 5,000 square meter installation was all a rooftop-based system that was installed in 2007. At that point, that was the most optimal space that was available for these collectors. And since then, that additional 3,200 squares of collector area became available where all the research panels behind me was installed. The research partnership of Solid with the research institutes in Austria also included parabolic trough collectors as well as evacuated tube collectors. With this research, they can now establish optimal efficiency and temperatures and see how the optimization of square meterage versus energy delivery versus the best application of thermal energy for the district heating systems can be achieved. What Solid has done here is, in preparation for scaling up larger scale district heating solar systems, they installed collectors of seven different manufacturers to test and also monitor the efficiency and preparation to scale up this renewable thermal heating. Of this entire 5 megawatts or 8,200 squares of solar collectors, there's only 100 square meters of a specific brand of collector that's been discontinued. The entire capacity is still functional, is still being serviced and maintained by Solid, and we've had 15 years, in excess of 15 years, of clean, beautiful solar thermal heating going into the district heating loop. So here's some crazy numbers. The district heating system of Graz requires a peak load of 550 megawatts of thermal energy. So this plant that we've got, the 5 megawatts, is feeding in to this main district heating plant. And behind me, you can see the larger chimney is combined gas and oil heating turbine, and then this smaller capacity. So it is primarily only heating, not power production, it's only heating. So the solar plant, the solar installation, basically feeds into the same network of these heating power plants, and there from that point it's distributed into the Graz district heating system. As mentioned, this system is run as an ESCO, so an energy services company, which sells that energy into this grid. And in my opinion, one of the better models in any solar thermal installation, because it places the responsibility of the servicing and the energy delivery with the supplier, and the guarantee that this plant runs optimal, because the only output that's being invoiced to the customer is the thermal energy delivery. And an ideal model, especially for longer term operational plants like these. So regarding the reticulation of this district heating system, you can see that there is two main lines. The bottom, let's call it yellow colored line, that is waste heat coming from the gas power production plant, where they basically use the waste heat from the electricity power production from those gas units, and that is brought into this plant as well. And then the top silver line is the district heating line going to the western part of Graz. In the back there at the top, which is not as visible on this video, is then the solar lines with the solar heat that delivers heat in excess of about 85 degrees into this grid for the district heating. The reticulation network feeds directly into the district heating power plant, with heat exchangers in place to deliver that peak thermal solar energy into the district heating system.